Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to show you how you can keep your live paint groups and still use them. So we're going to build this one on the right side, and the base artwork looks like so. There are a lot of open paths and some are closed, and from this we can build a map. So looks like that. And you can select all of them and then go to the Shape Builder tool, and below it there's the Live Paint Bucket tool. And then you can use the arrow keys to select a color, and the selection icons are in the options. I'm going to double click the Live Paint Bucket, and you see this is the cursor swatch preview. And you can use the arrow keys to select a color and then just click inside and paint this. And use the arrow keys again and paint the next one. Just like so. It's pretty simple and it's nice because the artwork stays editable that way. So let's just paint these and then select the last color and paint those. Now you can just get rid of those lines. Just select that live paint group and then go up here and set the lines to none. It looks like so. Now you have these shapes, but they are not shapes. They are still those open paths, and you can still edit it. You can go in here and just move this around and the fill will adapt. That's nice because, well, editable is a good thing. You can make changes to it until the very last minute. But now you want to have this as well. So how can you use your shapes? You cannot select them with the direct selection tool, but the Live Paint tool has its own selection tool, which is the Live Paint selection tool. And with it, you can select those shapes that don't exist. So you can click on it and select, and with the Shift key, select the other ones as well. And then you can copy them and then paste them. I'm going to paste them so you see it. Just paste them here, and you see these are just plain shapes. So let's go in here and paste them in place. Just go to edit and paste in place, and there they are. And now, in order to unite them, there are several methods. Of course, you can use the Pathfinder and unite them. You can group them and then use Pathfinder effects. Or you can create compound shapes, which is what we're going to do. I'm going to select Window and Pathfinder and then press the Alt key and unite them. So this is now a compound shape, as you can see up here. And this compound shape can get the striped fill. I've got a graphic style of that, and just apply it like so. And then we can also apply a stroke. Let's make that black and like so. So this can be freely moved around and used, and the live paint group is still there, so you can edit it. And just in case your editing changes some of these as well, then you can very quickly create a new one. You just use the Live Paint selection tool and copy them and then make a compound shape. It's far easier to just copy some shapes than having to start from scratch with a Live Paint group. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.